A well-established mind, a mind which is in a state of samyukti, is referred to as a kalpavriksha. If you organize your mind to a certain level of organization, it in turn organizes the whole system. Your body, your emotion, your energies, everything gets organized in that direction. Once all these four dimensions of you, your physical body, your mind, your emotion, and the fundamental life energies are organized in one direction. Once you are like this, anything that you wish happens without even lifting a little finger actually. It would help to assist it with activity, but even without doing any activity, you can still manifest what you want. If you organize these four dimensions in one direction and keep it unwavering in that direction for a certain period of time. Right now the problem with your mind is, every moment it is changing its direction. It is like you want to travel somewhere, and every two steps if you keep changing your direction, the question of you reaching the destination is very remote unless it happens by chance. So, organizing our minds and in turn organizing the whole system and these four basic dimensions of who you are right now in one direction, if you do this, you are a kalpavriksha yourself. Anything that you wish will happen. But right now, if you look at your lives, everything that you have wished for till now, if it happens, you have finished. Everything and everybody that you have desired for, if all of that lands up in your house today, could you live with that? So if you want to become empowered, it is also important that you become responsible as to what you ask for and what you don't. Right now the world situation is just this, we are hugely empowered with technology. Today it doesn't take six billion people to destroy this planet. One man by pressing the wrong button can destroy the whole planet. When we are empowered like this, it's very important that our physical action, emotional action, mental action and energy actions are controlled and properly directed. If it is not so, we become destructive, self-destructive. Right now, that is our problem. The technology, which is supposed to make our life beautiful and easy, has become the source of all the problem that we are destroying the very basis of our life, which is the planet. So what should have been a boon, we are making a curse out of it. What has brought incredible levels of comfort and convenience to us in the last 100 years or so, has also become a threat to our life simply because we are not conscious action, we are in a compulsive state of action. So organizing our minds fundamentally means moving from a compulsive state of activity to a conscious state of activity. You might have heard of people for whom they asked for something and beyond all expectations it came true for them. Generally this happens to people who are in faith. Now, let's say you want to build a house. If you start thinking, oh, I want to build a house, to build a house I need 50 lakhs, but I have only 50 rupees in my pocket, not possible, not possible, not possible. The moment you say not possible, you're also saying I don't want it. So on one level, you're creating a desire that you want something, on another level, you're saying I don't want it. So in this conflict, it may not happen. Someone who has some faith in a god or in a temple or whatever, who is simple-minded, faith works only for those people who are simple-minded. Thinking people, people who are too much thinking, for them it never works. A childlike person who has a simple faith in his god or his temple or whatever, he goes to the temple and says, Shiva, I want a house. I don't know how, you must make it for me. Now in his mind there are no negative thoughts. Will it happen? Will it not happen? Is it possible? Is it not possible? These things are completely removed by this simple act of faith. Now he believes Shiva will do it for him and it will happen. So is Shiva going to come and build your house? No, I want you to understand, God will not lift his little finger for you. What you refer to as God is the source of creation. As a creator, he has done a phenomenal job, there's no question about it. Could you think of a better creation than this? Is it in anybody's imagination to think anything better than what is there right now? So as a creator, he has done his job wonderfully well. But if you want life to happen the way you want it, because right now the very crux of your happiness and your well-being is this. If at all if you're unhappy, the only and only reason why you're unhappy is life is not happening the way you think it should happen. That's all it is. So if life is not happening the way you think it should happen, you're unhappy. If life happens the way you think it should happen, you're happy. It's as simple as that. So if life has to happen the way you think it should happen, first of all, how you think, with how much focus you think, how much stability is there in your thought, and how much reverberance is there in the thought process, will determine whether your thought will become a reality or is it just an empty thought. Or how you do not create any impediments for your thought by creating negative thought process. Is something possible or not possible? Is destroying humanity. What is possible and not possible is not your business, it's nature's business. Your business is just to strive for what you want. Right now you're sitting here. If I ask you two simple questions, I want you to just look at this and answer this. Right now from where you're sitting, can you just fly off? You say no. Right now from where you're sitting, can you get up and walk? You'll say yes. What is the basis of this? Why you say no to flying and yes to walking? Because past experience of life, many times you've gotten up and walked, never did you fly off. Or in other words, you're using the past experience of life as a basis for deciding whether something is possible or not possible. Or in other words, you have decided that what has not happened till now cannot happen in your life in future. This is a disgrace to humanity and the human spirit. What has not happened till now on this planet can happen tomorrow. Human beings are capable of making it happen tomorrow. So what is possible and what is not possible is not your business. That is nature's business. Nature will decide that. You just see what is it that you really want and strive for that. And if your thought is created in a powerful way without any negativity, without any negative thoughts bringing down the intensity of the thought process, it will definitely manifest. The whole existence today, modern science is proving, is just a reverberation of energy. It is a vibration. Similarly, your thought is also a vibration. If you generate a powerful thought and let it out, it will always manifest itself. So generally, people are using faith as a means to remove the negative thought. Today, once you have become thinking human beings, your faith is not too deep. It doesn't matter how much faith you think you have, somewhere doubts always crop up. Right now, the way your minds are made, this moment, if God appears right here, you will not surrender to Him. You will want an investigation whether He is really God or not. With this kind of mind, you should not waste your time on faith. So there is an alternative, which is commitment. If you simply commit yourself to creating what you really care for, now once again, your thought gets organized in such a way, there is no such thing as whether it's possible or not possible. There is no hurdle in your thought process. Your thought flows freely towards what you want. Once this happens, making it happen will also naturally follow. So to create what you really care for, first and foremost thing is that what you want must be well manifested in your mind, that this is what I want. Is that what you really want? You must look at it, because any number of things in your life you have thought this is it, the moment you reach there you realize that's not it, it's the next one and the next one and the next one. So what is it that one really wants is one thing. First of all, we must explore. Once that is clear, and we are committed to creating it, now there is a continuous process of thought in that direction. Once you can maintain a steady stream of thought without changing direction, definitely this is going to happen in your life, or it will definitely manifest as a reality in your life. So, either you make this human form into a kalpa vriksha, or you make it into one big mess, which is happening all over. One reason why we have not created the kind of world that all of us would want to live in is, too many people are busy looking up. Too many people are interested in other planets, they are not interested in this planet. For every aspect of their life, they're checking out with other planets. And further, too many people are in service of heaven, they're not on service of this earth. I think right now we need people who are in service of this earth, not heaven. I believe if heaven is closer to divine than where we are, if that is so, I believe they're a little more organized than us, they don't need help from us. This has been a major problem on the planet. Anything that is valuable for a human being, anything that is good, the highest aspects of human life have unfortunately been exported to heaven. For example, if you say love, people say God is loving. We do not know whether God is loving or not. Human beings are capable of love. It is very, very important that people understand human beings are capable of love, human beings are capable of compassion, human beings are capable of joy and blissfulness. All the good things that are possible for a human being, unfortunately, have been exported to heaven. If we want to create the kind of world that we want to, we need to understand whatever you refer to as God, the idea of God has entered our mind only because we have seen creation around us. Because there is creation, we have assumed a creator. God is a great creator. What you refer to as God is a source of creation. That source of creation has not failed us, has done a fantastic job. But now the question is about management. If you want to leave the management in the hands of the creator, he will manage it in his own way, according to his agenda. But that's not what you want. You want life to happen the way you want it. Now, for example, let's say all of you here are the India soccer team for the next World Cup, and I'm the coach. So these next 4 years, everything that you need to know about football is taught to you. Everything that I know about football is poured into you in so many ways. Now, the time to play the match has come. You're on the field and the ball comes near your foot, but you look at me, then it's no good. You've seen those coaches sitting there and boiling, nothing happens. Because now, once you're on the field, it's your job. So this is the same thing. The creator has done a fantastic job. Now you're here. It is for you and me to see how to manage this, how we want it, how to keep this world, how… in what condition would all of us enjoy it best is something that we have to look at. So at every stage in our life, we tend to think, this is it. If this one thing happens, everything will be fine with my life. You reach there and you realize that's not it, and you postpone it to something else and something else, this is going on. The first and foremost thing is, you must be clear what is it that you really want. If you do not know what you want, the question of creating it doesn't arise. If you look at what you really want, what every human being wants is, he wants to live joyfully, he wants to live peacefully. In terms of its relationships, he wants it to be loving and affectionate. Or in other words, all that any human being is seeking for is pleasantness within himself, pleasantness around him. If this pleasantness, if it happens in our body, we call this health and pleasure. If it happens in our mind, we call this peace and joy. If it happens in our emotion, we call this love and compassion. If it happens in our energy, we call this blissfulness and ecstasy. This is all that a human being is looking for. Whether he is going to his office to work, he wants to make money, build a career, build a family, he sits in the bar, sits in the temple, he is still looking for the same thing. Pleasantness within, pleasantness around. If this is what we want to create, I think it's time we addressed it directly and commit ourselves to creating it. So you want to create yourself as a peaceful human being, joyful human being, loving human being, a pleasant human being on all levels. And do you also want a world like this? A peaceful world, a loving world, a joyful world. No, I want greenery, I want food. When we say a joyful world, that means everything that you want has happened. So this is all that you're looking for. So all that you need to do is commit yourself to creating it, to create a peaceful, joyful and loving world, both for yourself and everybody around you. Every day in the morning, if you start your day with this simple thought in your mind, that today, wherever I go, I will create a peaceful, loving and joyful world. If you fall down 100 times in the day, what does it matter? For a committed man, there is no such thing as failure. If you fall down 100 times, 100 lessons to be learnt. If you commit yourself like this to creating what you really care for, now your mind gets organized. Once your mind gets organized, the way you think is the way you feel, your emotion will get organized. Once your thought and emotion is organized, your energies will get organized in the same direction. Once your thought, emotion and energies are organized, your very body will get organized. Once all these four are organized in one direction, your ability to create and manifest what you want is phenomenal. You are the creator in many ways. Why I am saying you are the creator is, I want you to look at the nature of your life right now. If you eat a banana, in 4 hours' time, this banana becomes a human being. There is something within you, a life-creating process, a process which builds this body. The manufacturer of this body is within. You give him a banana, he makes a human being out of that banana. Transforming a banana into a human being is not a small thing. It is a phenomenon. It is just that this phenomena is happening within you unconsciously. If you could only consciously manifest this, making a banana into a human being, you are the creator. You are nothing less than that. As the theory of evolution goes, to make a monkey into a human being, it took millions of years. Over an afternoon, you can make a banana into a human being or whatever else, a piece of bread that you eat, into a human being. So, the very source of creation is functioning within you. If you organize these four dimensions of mind, emotion, body and energy in one direction, the source of creation is with you. You are the creator, what you want to create will happen to you effortlessly. Once you're organized like this, now you are not a mess. You are a kalpa vruksha. You have the power to create what you want. There are tools and technologies as to how to organize the system in such a way that instead of being a psychological mess, you can make yourself into a kalpa vruksha. This culture, these traditions, the whole technology of yoga is just about this, transforming yourself from being just a piece of creation to the creator himself. This is not in search of God, this is in search of becoming a God. This is not in search of divine, this is in search of becoming divine, because that which you call as divine, that which is the source of existence, is throbbing within you every moment of your life. Otherwise, a piece of bread cannot become a human being in the course of an afternoon. So, shifting from being just a piece of flesh and blood to becoming a creator, there is a whole science and technology for this. There are tools to make this happen. That which is the source of creation is functioning within you every moment of your life. It is just that, have you kept access to that dimension or not? Organizing the four basic elements of your life will give you that access. There are tools and technologies to do this. The whole science of yoga, the whole technology that we refer to as yoga is just about this, transforming yourself from being just a piece of creation to become a creator. For example, 100 years ago, if I picked up something like this and I start speaking to someone who is across in another part of the world, you would think it's some kind of a miracle. Either I must be a messenger or a son or maybe God himself. But today, this is just another gadget that every one of us carry and use. Today sitting here without using this instrument, if I speak to someone in another part of the world, it is still a miracle for you. So, this instrument happened because of human mind wanting it to happen. 100 years ago, nobody thought this was possible, but today it is just a common thing. Similarly, many, many, many things which are not in our perception yet can be brought into our perception, and our ability to create our lives can be greatly enhanced. So first and foremost thing is to organize the mind and to organize your emotions, body and energy in that line. Once this happens, you are in touch with the fundamental life-creating process within you. Once you are in touch with it, once you are in excess of that power, you have the power to create. You have the power to create your life and your surroundings the way you want it. Because we have lost our power to create, we are making a mess out of ourselves and the world around us. If we operated as the true creator, as it is operating within us, creating this body for us, if we could create our lives with the same sense of organization and sense of purpose, this world and the human being would be in a completely different state. It is my wish and my blessing that every human being in this world should have this access to the source of creation within himself, so that he can function here as a creator, not just as a piece of creation. Everything we as human beings have created on this planet was essentially first created in our minds. All that you see, which is human work on this planet, first found expression in the mind, then it got manifested in the outside world. So one thing we need to understand is, the wonderful things that we have done on this planet and the horrible things that we have done on this planet, both have come from the human mind. So if we are concerned as to what we create in this world, it's extremely important that first of all we learn to create the right things in our mind, how we keep our minds. If we do not have the power to keep our minds the way we want it, what we create in the world is also going to be very accidental and haphazard. So learning to create our minds the way we want is the basis of creating the world the way we want. There is a wonderful story in the yogic lore. On a certain day, a man took a walk. He went for a long walk. Accidentally, unawares, he walked into paradise. Fortunate, isn't he? He just took a walk and he landed up in paradise. After this long walk, he felt little tired. So he thought, oh, I'm tired. I wish I could rest somewhere. He looked around. There was a nice tree, underneath which there was very cushiony grass. So it was inviting. He went and put his head down there and slept. After a few hours, he woke up, well rested. And he thought, oh, I'm well rested, but I'm feeling hungry. I wish I had something to eat. And he thought about all the nice things that he ever wanted to eat in his life. And instantly, all those things appeared in front of him. You need to understand, they have the services like that. Hungry people don't ask questions. Food came and he ate. stomach became full. Then he thought, oh, my stomach is full, I wish I had something to drink. All the nice things that he ever wanted to drink, he thought about it and all of them just appeared in front of him. Drinking people also don't ask questions, so he drank. Now with a little bit of alcohol in him, you know Charles Darwin told you, all of you are monkeys, your tail fell away. Not me, Charles Darwin told you that you were all monkeys and your tail fell away and then you became human. Yes, definitely the tail fell away. But the monkey, in yoga, we always refer to an unestablished mind as Markata, which means a monkey. Why we are referring to the mind as a monkey is, what are the qualities of a monkey? One thing about a monkey is, it's unnecessary movement. And another thing about the monkey is, if I say you're monkeying somebody, what does it mean? Imitation. Monkey and imitation have become synonymous. So these two essential qualities of a monkey are very much the qualities of an unestablished mind. Unnecessary movement, you don't have to learn it from the monkey, you can teach it to the monkey. And imitation is full-time job of the mind. So when these two qualities are on, a mind is referred to as a monkey. So this monkey became active within him. He just looked around, thought, what the hell is happening here? I asked for food, food came. I asked for drink, drink came. There must be ghosts around here, and ghosts came. Oh, the ghosts have come, they're going to surround me and torture me, he thought. Immediately the ghosts surrounded him and said to him, you will want an investigation whether he's really God or not. With this kind of mind, you should not waste your time on faith. So there is an alternative, which is commitment. If you simply commit yourself to creating what you really care for, now once again, your thought gets organized in such a way, there is no such thing as whether it's possible or not possible. There is no hurdle in your thought process. Your thought flows freely towards what you want. Once this happens, making it happen will also naturally follow. So to create what you really care for, first and foremost thing is that what you want must be well manifested in your mind, that this is what I want. Is that what you really want? You must look at it, because any number of things in your life you have thought this is it, the moment you reach there you realize that's not it, it's the next one and the next one and the next one. So what is it that one really wants is one thing. First of all, we must explore. Once that is clear and we are committed to creating it, now there is a continuous process of thought in that direction. Once you can maintain a steady stream of thought without changing direction, definitely this is going to happen in your life, or it will definitely manifest as a reality in your life. So either you make this human form into a kalpa vriksha, or you make it into one big mess, which is happening all over. One reason why we have not created the kind of world that all of us would want to live in is, too many people are busy looking up. Too many people are interested in other planets, they're not interested in this planet. For every aspect of their life, they're checking out with other planets. And further, too many people are in service of heaven, they're not on service of this earth. I think right now we need people who are in service of this earth, not heaven. I believe if heaven is closer to divine than where we are, if that is so, I believe they're a little more organized than us, they don't need help from us. This has been a major problem on the planet. Anything that is valuable for a human being, anything that is good, the highest aspects of human life have unfortunately been exported to heaven. For example, if you say love, people say God is loving. We do not know whether God is loving or not. human beings are capable of love. It is very, very important that people understand human beings are capable of love, human beings are capable of compassion, human beings are capable of joy and blissfulness. All the good things that are possible for a human being, unfortunately, have been exported to heaven. If we want to create the kind of world that we want to, we need to understand whatever you refer to as God, the idea of God has entered our mind only because we have seen creation around us. Because there is creation, we have assumed a creator. God is a great creator. What you refer to as God is a source of creation. That source of creation has not failed us, has done a fantastic job. But now the question is about management. If you want to leave the management in the hands of the creator, he will manage it in his own way, according to his agenda. But that's not what you want. You want life to happen the way you want it. Now, for example, let's say all of you here are the India soccer team for the next World Cup, and I am the coach. So these next 4 years, everything that you need to know about football is taught to you, everything that I know about football is poured into you in so many ways. Now, the time to play the match has come, you're on the field and the ball comes near your foot, but you look at me, then it's no good. You've seen those coaches sitting there and boiling, nothing happens. In a god or in a temple or whatever, who is how simple-minded? Faith works only for those people who are simple-minded. Thinking people, people who are too much thinking, for them it never works. A childlike person who has a simple faith in his god or his temple or whatever, he goes to the temple and says, "Shiva, I want a house. I don't know how, you must make it for me." Now in his mind there are no negative thoughts. Will it happen? Will it not happen? Is it possible? Is it not possible? These things are completely removed by this simple act of faith. Now he believes Shiva will do it for him and it will happen. So is Shiva going to come and build your house? No, I want you to understand, God will not lift his little finger for you. What you refer to as God is the source of creation. As a creator, he has done a phenomenal job, there's no question about it. Could you think of a better creation than this? Is it in anybody's imagination to think anything better than what is there right now? So as a creator, he has done his job wonderfully well. But if you want life to happen the way you want it, because right now the very crux of your happiness and your well-being is this. If at all if you're unhappy, the only and only reason why you're unhappy is life is not happening the way you think it should happen. That's all it is. So if life is not happening the way you think it should happen, you're unhappy. If life happens the way you think it should happen, you're happy. It's as simple as that. So if life has to happen the way you think it should happen, first of all, how you think, with how much focus you think, how much stability is there in your thought, and how much reverberance is there in the thought process, will determine whether your thought will become a reality or is it just an empty thought. Or how you do not create any impediments for your thought by creating negative thought process. Is something possible or not possible? Is destroying humanity. What is possible and not possible is not your business, it's nature's business. Your business is just to strive for what you want. Right now you're sitting here, if I ask you two simple questions, I want you to just look at this and answer this. Right now from where you're sitting, can you just fly off? You say no. Right now from where you're sitting, can you get up and walk? You'll say yes. What is the basis of this? Why you say no to flying and yes to walking? Because past experience of life, many times you've gotten up and walked, never did you fly off. Or in other words, you're using the past experience of life as a basis for deciding whether something is possible or not possible. Or in other words, you have decided that what has not happened till now cannot happen in your life in future. This is a disgrace to humanity and the human spirit. What has not happened till now on this planet can happen tomorrow. Human beings are capable of making it happen tomorrow. So what is possible and what is not possible is not your business. That is nature's business. Nature will decide that. You just see what is it that you really want and strive for that. And if your thought is created in a powerful way without any negativity, without any negative thoughts, bringing down the intensity of the thought process, it will definitely manifest. The whole existence today, modern science is proving, is just a reverberation of energy. It is a vibration. Similarly, your thought is also a vibration. If you generate a powerful thought and let it out, it will always manifest itself. So generally, people are using faith as a means to remove the negative thought. Today, once you have become thinking human beings, your faith is not too deep. It doesn't matter how much faith you think you have, somewhere doubts always crop up. Right now, the way your minds are made, this moment, if God appears right here, you will not surrender, because now, once you're on the field, it's your job. So this is the same thing. The Creator has done a fantastic job. Now you're here, it is for you and me to see how to manage this, how we want it, how to keep this world, how… in what condition would all of us enjoy it best is something that we have to look at. So at every stage in our life, we tend to think, this is it. If this one thing happens, everything will be fine with my life. You reach there and you realize that's not it, and you postpone it to something else and something else. This is going on. The first and foremost thing is, you must be clear what is it that you really want. If you do not know what you want, the question of creating it doesn't arise. If you look at what you really want, what every human being wants is, he wants to live joyfully, he wants to live peacefully. In terms of its relationships, he wants it to be loving and affectionate. Or in other words, all that any human being is seeking for is pleasantness within himself, pleasantness around him. If this pleasantness, if it happens in our body, we call this health and pleasure. If it happens in our mind, we call this peace and joy. If it happens in our emotion, we call this love and compassion. If it happens in our energy, we call this blissfulness and ecstasy. This is all that a human being is looking for. Whether he is going to his office to work, he wants to make money, build a career, build a family, he sits in the bar, sits in the temple, he is still looking for the same thing. Pleasantness within, pleasantness around. If this is what we want to create, I think it's time we addressed it directly and commit ourselves to creating it. So you want to create yourself as a peaceful human being, joyful human being, loving human being, a pleasant human being on all levels. And do you also want a world like this? A peaceful world, a loving world, a joyful world. No, no, I want greenery, I want food. When we say a joyful world, that means everything that you want has happened. So this is all that you're looking for. So all that you need to do is commit yourself to creating it, to create a peaceful, joyful and loving world, both for yourself and everybody around you. Every day in the morning, if you start your day with this simple thought in your mind, that today, wherever I go, I will create a peaceful, loving and joyful world. If you fall down 100 times in the day, what does it matter? For a committed man, there is no such thing as failure. If you fall down 100 times, 100 lessons to be learnt. If you commit yourself like this to creating what you really care for, now your mind gets organized. Once your mind gets organized, the way you think is the way you feel, your emotion will get organized. Once your thought and emotion is organized, your energies will get organized in the same direction. Once your thought, emotion and energies are organized, your very body will get organized. Once all these four are organized in one direction, your ability to create and manifest what you want is phenomenal. You are the creator in many ways. Why I am saying you are the creator is, I want you to look at the nature of your life right now. If you eat a banana, in 4 hours' time, this banana becomes a human being. There is something within you, a life-creating process, a process which builds this body. The manufacturer of this body is within. You give him a banana, he makes a human being out of that banana. Transforming a banana into a human being is not a small thing. It is a phenomenon. It is just that this phenomena is happening within you unconsciously. If you could only consciously manifest this, making a banana into a human being, you are the creator. You are nothing less than that. As the theory of evolution goes, to make a monkey into a human being, it took millions of years. Over an afternoon, you can make a banana into a human being or whatever else, a piece of bread that you eat, into a human being. So, the very source of creation is functioning within you. If you organize, these started torturing him. Then he started screaming in pain and said, oh, they're going to kill me, and he died. Just now he said he's a fortunate being. The problem is he was sitting under a kalpa vriksha or a wishing tree. He asked for food, food came, he asked for drink, drink came, he asked for ghost, ghost came, he asked for torture, torture came, he asked for death, death happened. Now don't go looking for these kalpa vrikshas in the forest. You can barely find a tree these days. A well-established mind, a mind which is in a state of some yukti, is referred to as a kalpa vriksha. If you organize your mind to a certain level of organization, it in turn organizes the whole system. Your body, your emotion, your energies, everything gets organized in that direction. Once all these four dimensions of you, your physical body, your mind, your emotion, and the fundamental life energies are organized in one direction, once you are like this, anything that you wish happens without even lifting a little finger actually. It would help to assist it with activity, but even without doing any activity, you can still manifest what you want. If you organize these four dimensions in one direction and keep it unwavering in that direction for a certain period of time. Right now the problem with your mind is, every moment it is changing its direction. It is like you want to travel somewhere, and every two steps if you keep changing your direction, the question of you reaching the destination is very remote unless it happens by chance. So, organizing our minds and in turn organizing the whole system and these four basic dimensions of who you are right now in one direction, if you do this, you are a kalpa vriksha yourself. Anything that you wish will happen. But right now, if you look at your lives, everything that you have wished for till now, if it happens, you have finished. Everything and everybody that you have desired for, if all of that lands up in your house today, could you live with that? So if you want to become empowered, it is also important that you become responsible as to what you ask for and what you don't. Right now the world situation is just this, we are hugely empowered with technology. Today it doesn't take six billion people to destroy this planet. One man by pressing the wrong button can destroy the whole planet. When we are empowered like this, it's very important that our physical action, emotional action, mental action and energy actions are controlled and properly directed. If it is not so, we become destructive, self-destructive. Right now, that is our problem. The technology which is supposed to make our life beautiful and easy has become the source of all the problem that we are destroying the very basis of our life, which is the planet. So what should have been a boon, we are making a curse out of it. What has brought incredible levels of comfort and convenience to us in the last 100 years or so has also become a threat to our life simply because we are not conscious action, we are in a compulsive state of action. So organizing our minds fundamentally means moving from a compulsive state of activity to a conscious state of activity. You might have heard of people for whom they asked for something and beyond all expectations it came true for them. Generally this happens to people who are in faith. Now, let's say you want to build a house. If you start thinking, oh, I want to build a house, to build a house I need 50 lakhs, but I have only 50 rupees in my pocket, not possible, not possible, not possible. The moment you say not possible, you're also saying I don't want it. So on one level, you're creating a desire that you want something, on another level, you're saying I don't want it. So in this conflict, it may not happen.